Hi, I'm Graham Thompson from Trail Magazine, and today we're looking at boots for going to the Alps with. What we're going to do is look at boots that are really good for snow, right the way down to boots that are maybe a bit more dedicated to being on rock. Okay, these are the first ones we're going to look at, and as you can see, they're a pretty big, chunky, nice, colourful boot. Look great on the hill. But when we look a bit closer, what have we really got? Well, the interesting thing is they're actually quite heavy. In fact, they're the heaviest pair here. When we look underneath, we've got a really incredible grip on there, really nice deep lugs, which seems to be great on the snow. And also, there's lots of insulation in here. And we've got a double tongue, which just makes it nice and easy to do up, and lots of protection for your foot, and a bit of insulation there actually as well. And when we look at the boot, we can see the profile here of the boot is fairly round. It's fairly comfortable to wear, great for general walking. Not quite so good for when you're doing climbing, though. But more importantly, perhaps, is we notice we've got a big lug here and one at the back as well. This means we can put clipping crampons in, which makes it really quick to throw crampons onto these, and they're going to stay there all day, nice and secure. They're the main features. There's a slight curve on the sole, which means you're going to be able to walk fairly easily. Nice big heel breast for getting a bit of grip as well. But generally, this is going to be a really nice boot for when you've been trudging in snow most of the day and going up to quite high altitudes, as it is very insulated. When we look at the ankle cuff, it's very supportive. You put a hand in there and try and flex it, it's getting a lot of support, which means you're going quite uneven terrain as well, because the boot is going to support your ankle and keep it all fairly straight, which is just what you need in that sort of terrain. So a good all-round, solid, out-on-the-snow sort of boot, and insulated as well, so you can go up to quite high altitudes in this. Okay, this next boot is a sort of a good all-rounder, really. It'll do a bit of everything. Which is probably what you're going to need most of the time, to be fair, when you're out on the Alps, because one minute you're on glaciers, then you're on snow slopes, and then, whether you want to or not, you're going to be on rock as well. So this boot, as you can see from the profile, it's nice and straight on the edges there, which means it's a little bit better just for climbing. We've still got a very aggressive sole, and we've got a reasonable bit of curvature on here, so the boot rolls quite nicely when you're walking, and we can still get clip-on crampons. We've got a lug at the heel and at the toe, and a nice lump of rubber as well to protect the boot. It's a little bit lighter than the other models as well, but it's a good all-rounder that's going to do sort of pretty much everything. And if you want one boot, probably, this is the sort of thing probably to go for, as you can go everywhere with it. Okay, we've got this next boot. Like most things in the outdoor industry, things are getting lighter when we look at footwear, and these are very light, a lot lighter than the other models we've looked at. But they're still really good for doing fairly technical terrain. At the toe, they've got a nice little lug here for fitting crampons, and at the heel as well, which means you can get crampons on nice and quick. Still got a nice aggressive sole unit, a bit of curvature in there to make it nice and easy to walk with. But the support isn't quite so good in the ankle, so you're going to have to be a little bit better with your footwork when you're wearing these, and a little bit more prepared to work a little bit harder, perhaps. But they're a really nice technical boot. They've got a really unusual lacing system on the front here, which basically means you tighten up this screw and these wires, which are basically the laces, crank on down. And you can do this with big gloves on. It's just really quick and simple to do, even if you're totally knackered or you've just woken up at 3 o'clock in the morning to go out and really start. So that's really nice. Better still is you can actually fit a gaiter to the top of the boot, which means you don't really have to have gaiters built into your trousers. You can just wear these, and we've tried these out, and no snow gets in your boots. Fantastic. So these are a good, lighter weight, but nice and technical shoe. They actually do everything, as long as you're up to the skill level yourself. Finally, we've got this boot, which is, again, nice looking, very light, but it's a slightly sort of different sort of boot than the others we've looked at. A little bit better for being on rock rather than in the deep snow. Got a nice little profile at the front here, which just means it's a little bit easier to climb with, and that's the big benefit of this. We haven't got the little bail at the front, so we can't put on quick fit stepping crampons, but we can use other crampons that still fit relatively easily. But not having that little bit of bail at the front just means it's a little bit easier to climb in these. And we've got a big rubber rand, which again is great for when you're climbing. There's not so much support in the ankle either, so again you have to work a little bit harder. So probably not the best boot for trudging through the snow all day, but really good if you're on rock most of the time and you just want some approach work going up the glaciers and across the snow.